going on, guys? Welcome to episode number 52 of Let's Play Mario and Luigi Dream Team for the Nintendo 3DS. Before we get started, if you can, do me a favor and hit that like button for me. Let's see if we can reach over 500 likes. If we can, I'll keep the Mario and Luigi Dream Team marathon going. Anyways, when we last left off, we left off here in Mush Rise Park after obtaining the fourth installment of the Ultabed. Today, we're going to be completing the Ultabed by obtaining the final part of it. And that, my friends, is the Driftwood Shore Jellyfish Sheets, I think is the name, or it's probably the Driftwood Jellyfish Sheets. I don't know. We'll take a look at it right now and see what it's called. It's the Driftwood Jellyfish Sheets. So their shore isn't actually in the title of the item, but that's the final thing that we need in order to complete the Ultabed. And once again, it's actually extremely easy to obtain. It's not hard at all. There's really no gimmick involved when obtaining this. All you need to do is just really work for it just by going in a cave and getting it out of that cave. And then bam, you got yourself the final piece of the Ultabed, and with that we'll be able to finally enter the dream world, find the Z-Keeper, and he will help us break the barrier between Neo Bowser Castle and the rest of Pillow Island. But yeah, I found another bean, that's cool. Hopefully today we'll run into some pillows, because it's been a while since we've ran into a pillow, and we are desperately in need for pillows, actually. Oh, let me get this. No, get out of there. Get out of there. Let me get this too. It's weird how I'm finding all of these beans lying around everywhere. It's like I'm not even trying, but yeah, all these beans are here. Anyways, I think if we go left, we'll actually make our way to Driftwood Shore. I'm not entirely sure, but what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna take the warp pipe there because it's a lot easier and it's much more convenient. It saves us a lot of time. Yeah, see, it would have took us to the entrance, like the shopping part area of Driftwood Shore, which is actually where I want to head towards, because we don't really know who to talk to about finding the last piece of the Ultabed. So, who's the one in charge of Driftwood Shore? It's that old weird lady who likes to sip on tea or coffee or something. There's always something in that little teacup that she's sipping on. Hey, look, it's Awesome Face Prod. He's just chilling here. There's so many of them, man. He's not even that awesome, because there are too many of them. It's hard to tell which one's the real one. They're all unoriginal and ununique. But anyways, let's go ahead and talk to her. It's his mom. You have the good timing, huh? Hee-hee, I want to show you this thing. What is it? We're kind of in the middle of something. The road to joy is full of detours. Okay. Look at this. What is that? It looks like a stone. I found this while stretching my legs on the beach. It is, how you say, antique and classy. Any madame of class knows exactly what this is. Well, geez, I can't tell what it is, so I guess you're not classy. Wait a sec. Are these pillow characters? What's that? Let's see if you know how to read it, Dreambert. Those are definitely pillow characters. Allow me to take a closer look. All right. Ah, I see. What? Just tell us what it says already. Pirates once roamed the seas in this region. This object appears to contain information. Yes, it refers to the treasure of those pirates. Pirates' treasure? I wonder what it could be. We're looking for something and there happens to be treasure lying around here. I wonder if it could be the Driftwood sheets that we're looking for. What if the treasure is one of the Ultabed parts? It may be worth checking it out. Indeed, as for this location of the treasure, there is a hidden cave somewhere on this beach, but the lithograph doesn't say exactly where it is. There's also some sort of code to open the cave here. A code? What do you mean a code? I'm not entirely sure yet. The passion of adventure sizzles. The lithograph, you may have it.
And we obtained an old lithograph, which is gonna help us find the final piece of the Ultabed, I hope.
We should go look for that treasure. Where could the hidden cave be? We need to comb this beach thoroughly.
Alright, so that's exactly what we're gonna be doing today. We're gonna be looking for this hidden cave. But the good thing is, I figured this out right away, because I remember when I was here exploring Driftwood Shore, there was something that I actually stumbled upon or across, I guess, and I didn't really know what it was, and it had absolutely no use for me at the time I was here, so I thought it was something that we'd have to come back to later in order to, like, either get something or maybe there was something hidden in there. I wasn't entirely sure what it was, but I really didn't think anything of it. But I now know exactly where we need to head towards, because I've explored this place thoroughly. I've looked everywhere to make sure that I wasn't skipping over anything. Plus the fact that they threw all four different seahorses in all the locations of this place goes to show that they want you to explore this area and not miss over anything. But there's a couple of beans here that I want to grab quickly. A stash bean, and I'm pretty sure that's it's a defense bean. I was going to say it's another stash bean, but I guess I was wrong. Oh my god. These things aren't that bad. What are the worst? Okay, so next to the bandits, I have a new, like, enemy that I really, really, really hate. And you guys are about to find out what that enemy is. They're literally the worst. They're like those little hermit crabs with, like, the shells on their backs or the rocks. I don't know what it is on their backs, but they carry something on their backs. And it's so annoying because they'll attack you and they'll take so much HP from you. It's extremely annoying. But as you see on the map, that's the only area that we haven't actually scouted upon yet. And when we were here for the first time, it's something that you will stumble upon. And you're going to wonder, how do I get past this part? Because as you can see, it's all closed. One might think you might need to jump over it, but that's not the case. We're gonna go ahead and talk to it and see what happens. Could this be the hidden cave? Yes, I am getting a hidden vibe from it. Wow, a hidden vibe. Wow, you're so cool, man. Up there, more pillow text. What does it say? It says, alter the code if you wish to enter. What's the code then? Right, I'll just say the code written on the lithograph. Ahem. Pillow, Willow, Armadillo. Really? Pillow, Willow, Armadillo. That must be the best code ever. If that's seriously the code, I'm gonna, like, make all my passwords Pillow, Willow, Armadillo. Don't look at me, I didn't make it up. Oh my god, he wasn't even joking. It is Pillow, Willow, Armadillo. That is one of the most interesting codes I've ever heard in my entire life. But I guess it worked. Ah, it opened! As I sense, this is the hidden cave. Let's go find the treasure. Alright, so this cave, guys, is actually pretty straightforward. It opened. They're hunting treasure. Oh, score! Now's our chance. Ha, I bet you don't know who's talking right now. You guys will only find out at the end of the episode. That, oh my god, these things hit us. I thought I was, like, on a ledge. But these things are the worst things. If I trip, then I'll be pissed. I tripped. Alright. Oh, yeah. Alright, so I'm gonna show you the worst spam of this. See that? It's like they will literally all attack you and they'll take so much HP from you, like 32 plus HP. And when you do kill them, they will literally give you jack crap for EXP. So they're honestly extremely pointless in battling because, one, they're really difficult to kill. Two, you don't get any EXP out of it. So what's the point? That's right, there's no point. There's absolutely no point in battling these things. But yeah, this cave is pretty straightforward. There's actually a pillow that's here. And it's been a while since I've trained or at least fought any enemies. So inside of that cave or inside of the pillow, I'm actually going to take that as the opportunity to battle all the enemies in that cave just because I do gain a lot of EXP. Look at that. We found a new battle with a buddy of ours. It's Shy Guy. All right. This is going to be cute. This is cute, man. I literally just used a couple mushrooms and this is exactly what happens. They freaking attack me, which is lovely and wonderful. Let me go ahead and actually go ahead and use a nice super mushroom on the both of these guys. And something that I forgot to do was equipped my new badge. So there you go. This is the new badge that we got. Oh no, that's not it. It's this. Temporarily increases your power, letting you deal more damage to foes. And then if you switch the thing to the other one, it says, forms a barrier that reduces damage to zero for three attacks. Which is actually a really good one. This one temporarily increases defense and reduces damage dealt by enemies. That's also a really good one. But what I want is this one, the one that increases the POW. I tried it out and it actually does significantly increase your power. It makes you a lot stronger than you normally would have been. And I don't know how, for how many turns, because usually I kill the enemies right away. But it's a really, really convenient thing to have. And no wonder it was 5,000, because you get so many like different badge things to equip on with just that one purchase of the badge. So it makes me want to go back and purchase more badges, because that's something that I obviously want to invest my money in. Can this hermit crab run? Like, dude, come on, dude. We're not trying to play a game here. Just bolt. All right, sweet. He bolted. Exactly what I wanted. I don't even know if I'm heading the right way, but whatever. We'll figure it out. I think I need to go this way. Oh my god, hermit crab, get out of here. Alright. So what we need to do is we need to hit this thing. There's a thing over there. And by thing, I mean a button that we need to pound with our hammer. Once you pound that button, you smash it in, that bridge will go falling down and we'll be able to walk across that bridge. Which is cool. It's convenient, that's exactly what we needed to do. And probably on the way out, we'll hit this guy. I'm just hoping we don't. Hey buddy, how's it going, man? How's it going, buddy? Oh my god. Buddy boy, stay away from me. They're not worth it, man. Honestly, they are not worth the fight. They're not worth the trouble. Do I need to use a syrup jar? I'm almost positive that I actually... Yeah, I bought a Pilate at the start of the episode, I think. I don't know when I bought a Pilate, but I bought a Pilate sometime. Maybe it was at the start of the episode and I don't remember, but I'm 100% positive that I did, because there's absolutely no way I have perfect bro points right now. But yeah, the only way you could get across to that pillow is by, doing the tornado spin, and that's what we're gonna do right now. Yep. Okay, so I guess we have to use the ball to get up there, because it's not like we have to use the ball, but it's definitely the easiest way to get up there without leaving one of the bros behind. Okay, this I think we can just jump. Alright. And then we need to come to the corner like that. And then we need to start spinning, and there we go. We barely made it, but we actually made it to the pillow. So now we can go back on a pillow hunt and save a fellow pillowin from his nightmare chunk. And then we can get some clean training out of this. But here we are, guys, back inside of Dreamy Driftwood Shore. I bet you thought we were never gonna come back here. But what do you know, we did. We made it back here. Something that I discovered is you can actually hit enemies when you're on like a lower ledge, which is really awesome, to say the least. Now that I actually changed my badge, this badge meter won't reset. It'll actually continue going. Ah, did I even change? I don't know if I changed my badges. Probably not, because I'm pretty sure the badge meter should have reset. Okay, hold on. We'll figure this out once we're done with this. Whee! Whee! The best move to do in the game. I love this freaking move. It's because I've mastered it so well. I could do it perfectly. Oh, there you go. Start bragging and I fail, but I'll still get an excellent, because as long as the fire reaches all the other fires, we'll be good. Let me see. Did I not? Alright, there you go. Our badge meter reset. That's exactly what I needed. It sucks though, because I would have gotten two excellent hits and that would have increased my badge meter significantly. That's the only way you can increase your badge meter, is with excellent hits. Especially with this one, you'll notice that it'll fill up a lot slower than the normal badges that we actually were using throughout the full game. And that's because this is, and obviously has way better effects than all the other badges. But yeah, there you go. And then the final guy, and that'll hopefully increase it a little bit more. Oh yeah. There we have it, we killed him. Now, my friends, is one battle Luigi should evolve. I was gonna say evolve. No, he should become level 25 soon. I don't know when, but oh, there we go. Did we hit him or did he hit us? I don't know. Something happened. I'm pretty sure he hit us. Okay. We just gotta dodge these now. Nice. Very nice. They're attacking me like that. Alright. Let's go ahead and use a Luiginary Flame. Alright, here we go. A, B, 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 B. I'm pretty sure even though if I do like skip a hit or skip a Luiginary ball, I'll still get an excellent. Like, watch. Let me see if I can get the excellent. Wow, I still got the excellent. I don't know how, but I still did it. Alright, this is gonna be easy. Jump and jump. And they're back. Alright, one more time. And then they should all die. And then I just need to remember to use a syrup jar. Otherwise, I will forget and I'll have no bro points. Die, you stupid little spiny shells. It's my boy Lakitu. He's back in black. Alright. Come on, die. Alright, Lakitu's gonna attack me now. Where are the mushrooms, man? Where are the mushrooms, bro? Thanks, man. Bro, give me that mushroom. There we go. Aw, man, really? A herd of them came back? It's like you kill one and then six more spawn. Oh well, we'll definitely gain a lot of EXP out of this one though, because Lakitu plus all of these guys, the more there are, the more EXP you gain, and that's convenient. I have 14 bro points, exactly enough to do one more Luiginary Flame. It's like they wanted us to finish them off with this, but I definitely need to use a syrup jar after this, otherwise I won't have any more bro points to kill the rest of these guys. Alright, here we go. Die! They're all dead. Alright. And then we gained ourselves a level 25 with Luigi. What I want to actually do is increase Luigi's stash by 4. So now he's at 38. I would have increased his bro points, but it's not worth it. It's not. I mean, I don't really use any bro moves with Luigi, to be honest. So. Oh, there you go. I was about to skip that by skipping using an altar or a syrup jar. Yeah, I'm gonna just skip this battle, I guess. Because those guys don't really give you that much EXP. Aw, it's these guys. Did he hit us or did we jump on them? Oh, we jumped on them, apparently. Alright, cool. So that means they'll still get the first attack. Alright. There we go. Alright, so they should probably all die just off of one Luiginary Flame. If not, then definitely two. But it should do the trick. Alright, here we go. Here we go. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Look at that fireball. Oh my god, that is a huge one. Oh my jeez. Oh man. The captains didn't die, but the green ones all died. Ah, come on, dude. I had that one right there. Alright, let's do another one. Alright, here we go. And then that should actually almost push us up with our first badge meter for the increased POW. Which I don't know when I'm actually going to use it for the first time. I don't know. I'm probably just going to save it for something important. Alright, we got a great. Because we skipped over a huge fireball. But that's okay. We're going to go ahead and attack him with a hammer to the face. Oh, yeah. And they're dead. There we go. And now we're starting our way to level... We're making our way to level 26. Which is going to take us some time, actually. Unless we start battling stronger foes. I prefer battling dream world foes over, like, real world foes. Because you have to worry about Mario and Luigi rather than just Mario. So it kind of sucks, but you'll get used to it, I guess. But yeah, that was fun. We saved the pillow, we got some EXP, and we were able to do some battles here. Now, with all that being said, we can finally make our way up to the nice and clean... What's it called? What's that thing called? The Driftwood Shore Jellyfish Sheets? The Driftwood Jelly Sheets? Something like that. It's made out of jellyfish. They sting you a lot. Alright, so this is the final part that we actually are going to do in this episode. It's follow the rings. By following the rings, you'll make it to the sheets. Alright, so you need to head down here. And there's going to be another ring right there. So you're gonna follow those rings too exactly. And that will take us to the final part of the Ultabed. Alright, there we go! And that, my friends, is how you make it to the final part of the Ultabed. Is this the treasure? This is one of the parts of the Ultabed, the Driftwood Jellyfish Sheet. Alright! Tough luck! What? Who are these? It's Blue Shy Guys. Let us right to it. Oh man, they stole it. See ya! Hey! They stole the Driftwood Jellyfish Sheets from us. Don't let them get away. We must get the sheets back. Alright guys, we're gonna end off the episode here. Who knew that the Shy Guys followed us in here and would have stolen the sheets? I didn't know that, but honestly, it's really, really easy to obtain it back from them, and we're gonna be doing that in the next episode, because it'll probably take us some time just to catch up to them, and then battle them, and then get the Driftwood Jellyfish sheets back. So, thank you guys all so much for watching. In the next episode, that's exactly what we're gonna be doing. Make sure you hit that like button, and subscribe if you haven't, and I will see you in the next episode of Mario and Luigi Dream Team. Goodbye.